James Bond and the 007 series have been huge hits from their inception. A daring and cunning secret agent sent on highly sensitive missions, all the while fighting against dangerous adversaries. With the release of the newest installment in the series, No Time to Die, several different car companies have caught on to the craze and are now making their very own James Bond-esque cars. Stick around to learn more about these beautiful and intriguing cars that are guaranteed to catch your eye. British automotive engine engineering Vantar. While James Bond being British, it only makes sense that a British car company would create a car inspired by the secret agent. In early October, BAE announced that they would take Aston Martin DB9s and redesign them to look more like the DB5 that James Bond drives. They accomplished this through dressing the Astons in sheet metal, which gives the car a sleek metallic appearance. These modern DB5s run on modern equipment, however, with the cars featuring a V12 engine, an engine that's desired by many people across the globe. Aston Martin DB5 fiberglass body. Though this is only a replica of the body of the car, it's still a worthwhile option for anyone wanting to own their very own James Bond car. The auction site Bring a Trailer announced this car during the first week of October, which lines up perfectly with the release of No Time to Die. The car is priced at $65,000 and was handmade by producer The White Rock. Besides the body, the replica also features a right-hand dashboard, headlights and taillights, chrome grille, mirrors, headlights, a windshield, rear window rubber, and a finishing chrome trim. For people wanting a more complete car, however, the White Rock has also produced a complete replica of Bond's Aston Martin, which was priced at a whopping $200,000. Rocket League's Aston Martin Valhalla. Rocket League is a soccer game which utilizes cars rather than human players. Recently, an additional skin was added to the game, a Bond Aston Martin Valhalla car. Along with the Valhalla, a DB5 is available. Both were initially only unlockable through an achievement, but have since been made purchasable. To buy the skin, players will need to fork over 1,000 credits, which is expensive, but nowhere near the cost of the other replicas tying in with the movie. Tuxedo Black. Although most wouldn't associate Bond with a more rugged off-road vehicle, Heritage Black released a Defender with a James Bond flair for the latest film. The Jeep features a slick black coat of paint. The car has been described with several different Bond-esque phrases, including coated in special paint that's shaken, not stirred, and a car not to die for. The company describes itself as a contemporary studio for architecture, all adding to the car's spy flair. Although there are no mechanical differences that set the Tuxedo Black apart from other Defenders, it features much of the accessories in the Land Rover catalog. The Jeep has a price tag of $23,692, but is surely a car that would suit the secret agent himself. Lunaz DB6 Electric Conversion. The Lunaz DB6 is a unique tie-in car because of how the car is actually made. Lunaz made older classic cars such as Rolls-Royce and strips it to its bones. They then install a modern electric powertrain. To complement the modernized engine, Lunaz then boosts the auxiliary features to modern standards as well. Battery sizes range from 80 to 120 kilowatts and are fast charging. With its updated features, drivers could easily stop the car on a penny from full speed. With all these spy-themed cars coming out with the latest movie, fans may be left wondering, what's next for the series? When will the next movie come out? What can we expect in terms of plot development? There have been talks of Dev Patel acting as the new Bond, as well as talks of a new character taking on Bond's mantle. Stick around to learn more about what's coming for the 007 series. Who will be the next Bond? Since 2006, Daniel Craig has played the role of James Bond, beginning with Casino Royale. After 15 years, the character is ultimately killed off in No Time to Die. Someone will have to step up to take the legendary agent's role, but the question is, who? Cubby Broccoli has confirmed that the new Bond can be someone outside of the usual Bond role, a white, British, posh male? Yet Broccoli also said that the newest Bond will not be allowed to be female. Actors like Dev Patel and Luke Evans have been proposed as the next Bond, but ultimately, fans will have to wait to see who will take up the Legend's mantle. What's next for Bond? The biggest issue facing Bond in the modern day is his legacy. From his first inception back in the 60s, Bond had a womanizing and hyper-masculine depiction. In the modern age, however, this depiction has brought some issues. Yet, revamping the character is nearly impossible due to how ingrained Bond's personality is to his character. With the series free of Bond, this offers the franchise an opportunity to revamp the character's reputation through whoever ultimately takes up the exciting new chapter in the Bond franchise. New novel series. Perhaps a new source of inspiration for the next round of Bond movies could come from the recently announced book series by Kim Sherwood. The British novelist announced that she would begin writing a trilogy of Bond books which lack the titular character. Instead, the novels will focus on a new cast of 00 agents who will work against more modern threats, such as terrorism. Some fellow authors and fans, however, have shown resistance to this plan. Their biggest issue with attempting to modernize Bond is that it may distract from the identity of the series. Sherwood, however, is excited to bring the series into the 21st century and says that with the wealth of other 00 agents besides Bond, the potential is endless. New 00 faces. With Craig's Bond having died at the end of No Time to Die, the next Bond movie there will definitely be a new actor playing the star. Broccoli announced that they wouldn't begin looking for the next 007 until at least 2022. For Bond himself, some likely candidates are Dev Patel, Luke Evans, Tom Hardy, Henry Cavill, and Ryan Reynolds, but it's also likely that other 00 agents will be featured in the movies. With Bond's absence and the new novel trilogy, we can likely anticipate other agents to appear. It's possible to say who will play these new agents until 2022, though. Theories for Bond's replacement. One of the biggest theories fans have regarding who could become the next 007 was that Nomi would take on the role, as she had briefly taken on the 007 tag during the movie. Broccoli debunked the theory rather quickly, though, saying that a female shouldn't play Bond, when there are other notable roles in the series for women. Another theory is that Bond somehow survived the end of the movie and will star again in the next movie. This theory, however, is quickly debunked by the creators of the movie and by Daniel Craig himself. Craig had said he wouldn't want to play Bond again, and the movie creators have confirmed they will be searching for a new Bond in 2022. Potential spin-offs. No Time to Die introduced a lot of candidates for the next 007, chief among them being Nomi. Yet the filmmakers have also said that a female wouldn't be taking on Bond's legacy. So what can we expect to happen to these female leads? Besides showing up in future films, there have been talks of spin-offs focusing on the characters. Another potential spin-off would revolve around the Cuban intelligence operative Paloma. Although Bond's story is sealed and shut, both Nomi and Paloma's are still open. This leads to the potential of the franchise following these two characters, a move that fans approved of on social media. When can we expect the next film? A reboot will undoubtedly happen, but it's difficult to say when. Broccoli and other film producers have confirmed that they will begin to look for the next James Bond in 2022. Yet they have also said that they currently don't have any immediate candidates in mind and will begin searching when they finally do have some ideas. Looking to the past of this series, it seems likely that the newest film will be announced in the upcoming year. In 2002, Die Another Day was released but was the last Bond film of its era. 2 years later, Pierce Brosnan was dropped as Bond, mirroring Craig leaving the role behind. Although no forerunners are currently on the production team's mind, there are plenty of possible choices which should allow fans to look forward to the next movie's announcement soon. What is the past hint about the future? The Bond series isn't going anywhere anytime soon. It's become too culturally prominent to simply just die off. Following the end of the Daniel Craig Bond era, the series will reboot, just as it has in the past. The production team will likely attempt to wash off Bond's more womanizing, misogynistic traits to fit more within the 21st century. The next Bond movie will likely be what's referred to as a legacy-quel, or a sequel that features legacy characters and plot points, similar to the Star Wars sequels. In the past, the film series has followed the novels and their storylines. We can expect the same to happen with the announcement of the next movie. There you have it. Everything on both the newest Cars release for No Time to Die and the next James Bond movie. 5 cars are available for fans of the Super Spy, all with a unique James Bond flair. And with the possibility of new 00 agents being the focus in the next film, this franchise will keep fans coming back again and again. We hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching. We'll see you in the next one.